Welcome to the Breathing Color video discussing how to create a file for gallery wrapping. A brief overview of gallery wrapping would be a canvas print stretched onto a frame that also includes the print on the stretched portion of the frame. In Photoshop, let's make sure that we have our layers palette open. In our layers palette, we want to select the menu options and select Duplicate Layer. You have the ability to rename this layer, but in this case, we're going to leave it at Background Copy. Click OK. This duplicate layer is going to be the layer that will allow us to create the extra image that we need on the stretched portion of the frame. First thing we need to do now is we need to adjust our canvas size. Go to Image, select Canvas Size. We notice our current canvas size, or our actual image right here, is 22 inches by 16 inches. Let's say that we needed to add 2 inches all around our image to create that gallery wrap effect. We're going to change our width to 26, and we're going to adjust our height to 20 inches, and hit OK. Now, go to your tools palette and select the rectangular marquee in the top left corner. Now, starting in the top left of the image, we are going to click and drag the mouse to go across the entire image and select the white area that's above the print. Now that we have our selection, with the same tool, let's click and let's drag this down over the image. A trick to dragging this straight and evenly is to hold the Shift key on the keyboard. Click on your Edit menu and select Free Transform. We're going to grab the bottom middle button. Let's click and hold this and let's drag it to the top of the screen. And this is going to create our gallery wrapped effect for the top portion of the print. We're going to release our left mouse and we're going to hit Enter or Return on our keyboard. Now we have our duplicated section. Let's now do the same thing for the bottom portion of the print. Let's start in the bottom left corner, and we're going to click and drag to the right side. Once we have it where we need, we're going to release the left mouse, and we're going to go into our Edit menu and select Free Transform again. Go ahead and click and hold, and we're going to drag to the bottom of the screen. When you have it where you need to, release the left mouse and select Enter on your keyboard. Now that we have the top and bottoms, we need to do the sides. But before we do the sides, let's flatten this image. In your layers palette, select the menu options and go down to Flatten Image. The reason why we need to do this is because when we originally create a duplicate layer, the layer behind it still shows the white. So when flattening the image, now this is our one image to edit from. So we're going to go back to step one in the layers palette, and we're going to go to our menu options, and we're going to select Duplicate Layer. Hit OK. Now we have our duplicate layer in which to add the sides onto. Once we have our selection, let's move it over. Now that we have that, we're going to continue the same process. Edit menu, Free Transform. Select the right middle box and drag it over to the left. Hit Return on the keyboard. Now we have our left side. Let's do the same for our right side. Now that we have our area, let's drag it over while holding the Shift key again. And for the last time, we're going to edit and free transform. Hit return on the keyboard. and we have our gallery wrapped image. Let's go back to our layers palette and let's select from the menu options, Flatten Image. And that concludes the video on gallery wrapping for images.